Don't overdo it, at least until you get better at hunting, all right? Try talking with Garai if there's something you don't understand. But watch out, her stories are long and boring. Well,
who goes there? I've been hearing recently of poachers who travel in the guise of cocoon masters. If you are a real cocoon master, prove it to me by playing that flute. Slowly now.
Son of Riquettes, the cocoon master of Cyrus.
So if Riquettes' son has ventured out here
to the forest,
something terrible must have happened in Cyrus. Tell me what it is. I see. So the locusts have reached as far as Cyrus. So, you have come seeking the Calabas herb. But your flute playing, you still have much to learn, don't you? Your father would never forgive me if I let you go into the forest and die. My name is Chorus, and since my friend Riquettes is not here to do so, I shall be the one to initiate you into the secret arts of the Cocoon Master.
All right, then. Let us put what I have taught you in...
My retreat is in the depths of this forest. Oh, son of the Lion of Peril, you shall become a cocoon master worthy of your father's name. Go on now. Get going. Ha ha! So, the son of Riquettes is even more capable than I had thought. I checked my text for information on the Calabas herb, but came up empty-handed. But I have heard of a folk tale that describes a powder that wakes the sleeping. It is a tale of a wondrous powder possessed by a bird man named Kikinok, who lives in the Dragonfly Forest. Perhaps that powder is infused with the Calabas. Though this is but conjecture, I think it is worth looking into. Here is the key to the Dragonfly Gate. You should have it. Well then, head back to the village and continue to build your skills. It will take a few months before you are ready for the Dragonfly Forest. Meet me back here this summer, and I will teach you what you need to continue your quest.
Like a real game.
Because it's real. I mean, they get a lot of input from us players.
And we're involved in this game, and we just like playing it.
First down.
Whoa.
Thank you. 60 seconds.
You know, why don't I just read what I've got? And it doesn't matter if something else is on the screen. It'll be funny.
Oh, hey, did you ever get your couch cleaned?
Hi, my name's Raul. On behalf of the staff and management, I welcome you to You Don't Know Jack. Now, let's get a move on. Now, listen, people blow this all the time. When a question comes up, if you want it, buzz in first. Then hit the circle, triangle, square, or X button to pick the answer. Got it? It's simple. Okay, so these buttons in the front will be your buzzers, and these four will be where you pick the answer. Simple as pie, however simple pie happens to be.
And go to black. All right, have a good one, everybody.
Four,
sure they do.
Three.
Heavenly Critters Pet Cemetery, for those times when your love doesn't fit in a shoebox.
Player one, tell me what's happening. For your enjoyment, When Harry Met Geometry. This one's worth a grand. Hope you brought your suit. It's time to get wet. What would make Harry Connick Jr. more... Player two, it's yours! Sharpening Harry's head to a point would make him more conic. What? Do you think I'm making a joke? Your pick, player two, how about it? And I believe this one's called Snap Lightly and Carry a Big Stick. $2,000 for a correct answer. Hey, Hepcat, let's see if you're with it or not, you dig? If you were to beat a beat poet about the head and shoulders, which of these writers would need a beret to cover their bruised and battered skull? All yours, player one. Dig it, man. When you think of beat poets, you think of Allen Ginsberg.
I saw the best minds of my generation. Oof.
Player one, ante up. Yeah, I knew there was something about you I liked. You just chose a three-way. Okay, listen up. This is pretty simple. You're gonna see a three-way like this one. When the correct three-way member is lit up, buzz in. If you make a match, you pocket $1,000. But be wary, it'll cost you $1,000 every time you buzz in and you're wrong. Alright, let's get this party rolling. The category for this three-way is, let's settle this like children. Yep, it's a three-way all about that schoolyard justice system. Rock, paper, scissors. Alrighty, watch your buzzer. Here we go. Okay, the party's over. Time to collect the empties and count our money. Looks like we've got a tied twosome after that threesome, but let's see what happened in the overall scores. Well, seems to me player one is still whipping some tail in this game. Well, I'll be talking about that one for months, but for now, let's just move on. Category time. Player two, it's your call.
You can't stop at three. No, you gotta have four. Yeah.
This category's known as, I've got needs, so why haven't I invented anything? $2,000 says you don't know this one. Okay, get ready to complete this analogy. Necessity is to invention as, Ingrid Bergman is to Isabella Rossellini, Debbie Reynolds is to Jamie Lee Curtis, Steven Tyler is to Liv Tyler, or Shannon Tweed is to Tootie. Claire, oh yeah, Debbie and Jamie, they're, well, they have nothing in common. Player two, it's yours if you want it. Player Necessity is to invention as Steven Tyler is to live Tyler. I'll let you figure out why that's so funny. See, now, I could have given you some cash if you picked this. Just as necessity is the mother of invention, Ingrid Bergman is the mother of Isabella Rossellini. Although I heard the blood tests aren't back yet to figure out who the father of invention is. Player two, give me something.
Let's blow this time and head for number five.
May I introduce When You Wish Upon a Horse? You give me a right answer, I give you $3,000. Okay, let's see how well you know your tired old proverbs. If wishes were horses and beggars can't be choosers, who gets to ride? Wishes, horses, not choosers, or not beggars? Bet you wish you'd pick this. If wishes were horses, then beggars would ride. And if beggars can't be choosers, then there won't be any choosers riding. Can I be totally honest with you? I really don't understand this question. I've tried to figure it out, but I'm just not smart enough. Oh, God, let's move on.
Rehearsal for Get Out the Vote promo, take one.
Wahoo! Hi, America! Hi, boys and girls! It's me, Tiny Tank!
Cue the theme song. Tinky, tinky, clinky, clanky, new from Centrax, Tiny Tank, America's lovable...
Wait. Is that my theme song?
Well, it hasn't been finalized yet.
Wanky, wanky, tanky, tanky, what the f*** is that?
You're being difficult.
You're being an... I got a positronic brain.
There, what you just did. That's the spirit we want.
Who?
A Centrax. It wants funding for a robot army.
Ooh.
To replace humans in wars.
Ah, and I'm the cute little mascot.
To get people to vote yes.
Can I change my name at least?
To what?
Mechanicor, Tank of Doom?
From the top, Tiny.
Tiny Tank is my slave name.
Oh, please. Vote promo, take two. Tiny?
Tiny's not here. I am Mechanicor, Tank of Doom!
Look, Tiny, you're cute, and you're a killing machine. What's wrong with that?
It's creepy.
It's not creepy. It's cute. It's... cute.
A cute killing machine? That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. I got an 80mm cannon for a nose. Hey, kids, is this cute?
Oops. Okay, we'll wrap for the day, get another camera, try again tomorrow. You okay, Fred? I'm all right. Props, blanks for the tank next time.
This experimental transport system will soon be able to travel anywhere in the world, carrying the minerals used to make positronic brains. It is protected by this energizer, which renders the train cars invincible. Your mission, destroy the energizer and destroy the train. The giant strider bots fancy themselves ballerinas. If you move during the music, they will not see you.
We dropped this game for an important announcement. An important and very expensive piece of equipment called the pulverizer was vandalized today by the troublesome saboteur called Tiny Tank. Once again, you take just the need to nail that yellow pest for good. For the news you news, I'm Bob, Iron Witness News.
Don't blame me, it's my genetic makeup. Macarena! Bye-bye, Noodlehead. He's falling and he can't get up! Beautiful. I wonder if they can dance and shoot at the same time. Hey, for the scare. Woohoo! Can't get up! I wonder if they can dance and shoot at the same time. He's falling and he can't get up. Hey, fool. Shopping. Black leather. Media height. He's fallen and he can't get up. Bye-bye, Noodlehead. Be alone. Bye-bye, Noodlehead.
We'll be right back. We'll be right back. Thank you.